it's Granny Sue. I thought today we'd take a garden walk. I saw Tipper had done that, and you know, it's been on my mind for a while. So I thought, well, let's take a walk through the gardens. Walk from the house up the walkway here. You can see a lot of things that have already been on my blog, the flowers and things I've planted. We'll go down this busted up sidewalk. This one is due to be replaced this fall, I hope, if we get to it. You see, he put the stone wall on top of it, and that really cracked it. Don't know the name of this big guy. He's some kind of salvia, but other than that, I just like him. The bumblebees like him, too. And this is a little flower bed I've been working on this year, trying to get it to do something. And right now, I have a net on top of it so that our cat doesn't use it for his litter box. Got a lot of little seedling flowers coming up in there. I really don't want him to dig those up. So we'll see what kind of luck I have. The irises need to be cut back and dug out. There's too many. And then this is the little walled garden we've been working on for the past few years. I've got a little row of tenderette green beans up there along the walk. And there's some asparagus in the back. It mostly self-seeds. And the daylilies, of course, are in bloom. This is Larry's little melon patch. And hopefully they're going to crawl up the hill into that bare area up there. And we planted raspberries over here. We got them from Stark Brothers. The first planting, we got one plant. You can see that maybe coming up there. Second planting, got nothing. And the grapevine looks amazing, but the grapes are already getting black rot or whatever it is that they get every year. So next year, maybe we'll try to figure out how to stop that. Everything I have found talks about using some heavy chemicals, which I don't want to use. I've been weeding in here this morning. You can see where I've been pulling weeds. We've got little asparagus plants coming up, some cannas. The basil is down in there. They're kind of small, but I think they're coming along okay. And this is the old lettuce bed that's getting ready to be pulled out this evening. We'll replant. And red raspberry, and that red raspberry just died. No idea. Seemed to have any luck with raspberries. In front of it is a little patch of dill. And along the wall here, which we just put this in this spring, you can see I've got chamomile, chives, and parsley coming along. They're all pretty small right now, but they're growing. And a couple of tomato plants by the gate. I have no idea which ones they are. They're supposed to be cherry, but who knows. And then this asparagus has lots of seeds, so I'll be taking those and scattering them around, and hopefully getting some more asparagus. Let's see. We'll go through the gate. Go out to this other vegetable garden over here. You can see we've got electric fence around it with chicken wire on top. Not chicken wire, but a fishing line that keeps the deer out, supposedly. We'll find out. And these are our tomatoes. We have Better Boys, which I really like. Some black creme, which is my very favorite tomato. Some yellow tomatoes, some brandywines. So, gosh, what else is in here? I don't even know. Planted several different varieties. Over here are the stonehead cabbages. A few purple beans. They didn't do very well. I got those seeds from Gurney's, and I don't think I'll order from them again. And then we have a volunteer tomato, so he'll stay. And then up through here is a row of onion plants a neighbor gave us. So we put them in the ground. Another volunteer tomato. And then past there I have a pepper, and then the leeks. Not a very big patch of leeks this year. I didn't get that many plants out of what I started, but I'm happy with it. And then more purple beans. They're okay. They're just not doing like I remember them doing when I've grown them before. And of course, up here another volunteer potato plant. Then the onions, which are just about ready to pull. We'll probably pull them maybe this weekend. Another volunteer tomato. The cucumbers are growing here along the fence. Then you can see up here the beets. What's nice about mulch in the garden, we have cardboard underneath and then the hay, the mulch hay on top. And that keeps the weeds out, keeps the ground moist, and this year makes it so you can get in the garden when it's been raining. Over here is kale. And then this is butter crunch lettuce that's just about done. With a pepper at the end of the row. And we've planted more squash in here, I can't remember what we took out. Oh, peas, they didn't do any good. And then the squash plants, which are getting ginormous, but have yet to bloom. So I'm keeping my eye on them. And then there's the peppers. These are sweet bell peppers. And then carrots. And the carrots are doing pretty well. We've already had some of the carrots. Now, down there in the distance, I'm not going to walk down there right now. You can see there's the corn, which came up pretty spotty, so we've planted in between. And the cabbages, which we have covered, because something's getting under the electric fence. So those are late flat Dutch, great big cabbages, which I really like for making kraut. And then the potatoes are down there as well, and they seem to be doing all right. So that's a quick tour through the garden. If I can get out of here quick enough, I'll get up to the flower bed. I never know how long this phone is going to actually record. So so far, gardens look okay. It's taken a lot of side dressing to keep them going this year. I just ordered some more bone meal and blood meal, which we'll mix with wood ash and put out here for more fertilizing. And I see I've got weeds to pull. That's the other nice thing about mulch. There's not very many weeds, and you don't have to run the tiller. And then up on the bank, where I need to do my string trimming, is the big flower bed. And this one is doing pretty well. Things are kind of getting to the end of their bloom. But you can see back in there, there's a rose bush, feverfew, which is an herb. And here's where the pink poppies were, and they're pretty much done. And then, but there's a few coneflowers coming up that'll take that spot. And I see a lily back there too. And there's an old crock with a geranium in it. And this is yarrow, which is just about done as well. We made a pretty show. And I never planted that. That was another volunteer. And I have a little patch of calendula, the irises, which need desperate thinning out and cutting. The lamb's ears are almost done, but the bumblebees are still working them. And here you can see the garlic, some of the garlic, with the scapes curling on the top. And then some of my seedling flowers coming up down through there. And this is the coreopsis. And a little lemon lily. And some more seedlings back there, cosmos. So this garden is just about done with its spring blooming. And now we're going to get in here, cut back the iris, cut back the lamb's ears, cut back the yarrow. So there'll be a lot of cleanup to do in this garden. So that's a quick walkabout, just to kind of show you what the place looks like. And here's some little drift roses I just planted. And some more plants to go in, some rosemary, a hydrangea, and a couple of vincas, which will go in one of our tougher spots to grow things. And that's pretty much the walk through the garden. So I'm glad you got to come with me this morning. Maybe another day we'll do it again and see what's happening later on in the season.